but we'll keep on the soapbox until we've got a society that respects women and respects our needs. Women in this, here in Chester and around the region, in the start of the 20th century, began to fight for proper care for women when they were having babies and for contraception as a right. They were ridiculed and told they were ridiculous, that it was stupid. But they fought for it and they won. They established the 1946 NHS Act, which gave healthcare to everyone as a right. Think about it. Healthcare because you're a human being, not healthcare because you've got a checkbook or healthcare because you've got savings. Some of the women in the cooperative guild who fought for healthcare in the 30s told us of families where women had 18 children and 4 survived. We changed that, but now your right to have healthcare has been removed. The Secretary of State no longer has to provide healthcare for everyone.
Why not?
A long time, even before women got up on a soapbox and started shouting,
statutory
the landowners came along and stuck on churches like this.
They removed
a notice that said, "We are taking your land."
Yeah, exactly.
We didn't have
a referendum over that. Do we want the healthcare service or not? Technically, they don't have to provide
it anymore.
There was 48 when it was created, and it was changed in 2012. It was no longer a legal requirement.
It is that scale that we are facing now with the NHS.
Yes. How come we don't know that?
Sustainability and transformation plans are euphemisms, and all their documents are euphemisms. They intend to change our hospital onto the NHS, onto the United States model, where there are big regional areas, and those regional areas are put up for contract, put up for commissioning, sold off to for-profit healthcare. That is happening, and we think there's going to be formal announcements, believe it or not, on the 23rd of December. They are going to give us a Christmas present of the wrap of the NHS. Now, Margaret Greenwood, who's spoken here already, is moving a bill to reinstate the NHS. Jeremy Corbyn supports the reinstatement of the NHS. But the politicians alone can't do it. Every person here who uses the NHS has a responsibility to look and think, what can happen? What am I going to do? If all you do is actually talk to the person you live next door to, talk to the person in the doctor's waiting room, talk to the person when you go for a hospital appointment, talk actually at the school gate, those conversations build. We know from Save Liverpool Women's Hospital that most of our supporters plug on to the Facebook page when they're picking the kids up from school, and they talk when they're picking the kids up from school. Wherever you are, talk about the National Health Service. BBC is not going to tell people until the damage is done. If you want to do more than that, sign up as an activist. The activists within the NHS need now to get together and plan and organise. We need to go to the hospitals early in the morning and tell the people working there, A, what's going on, which a lot of which they know already, but they're at the sharp end, but that there is a campaign. There's a huge campaign building to save the NHS. If the suffragettes could fight and get the vote, we can save save the NHS. We can and we will save the NHS, but only if everyone gets involved and it becomes the biggest campaign this country has seen. Outdoing the poll tax, outdoing Stop the War. This has got to be the campaign that stops Theresa May in her tracks, that makes them realise the people of Britain want the NHS. We want the NHS free. Free at the point of need, paid for by taxation, and not for profit. Do your bit.